Oh, my, my. I think it's Monday. Monday morning it is. Monday, August 20th. It is now 7 o'clock. And if you're tuning in, you got it on the morning sound off with the Spaniard, yours truly. Happy Monday, everybody. It is 7 o'clock, 72 degrees out here in Chicago, 7 a.m. Central Time, 8 p.m. Eastern Time on the East Coast. Going to be a great day. It is Monday. Looks a little gloomy, but it's going to be a dry start to the day with a chance of showers and thunderstorms in the afternoon and evening hours. A few storms may be strong to severe, highs in the lower 80s. Tonight, showers and thunderstorms likely. A few storms may be strong to severe, lows in the upper 60s. So it's starting to feel a little bit like fall is coming. So yeah, it's back to school time. We're well underway for those of you parents who got our young little ones up and running this morning. Good morning to you. Have your cup of coffee, your tea, or whatever gets you going, your Irish coffee. I would love to have Irish coffee, but I still got a few more years until I retire, and I could do that for good, I think. Yeah. Oh, man. All right. Hey, good morning, everybody. This is the Spaniard keeping it tight from BlackSheep Bravo, and I am broadcasting live from red zone to green zone and everywhere in between. Welcome, everybody. Want to give a big shout out to the airmen over at the 27th Special Operations Aircraft Maintenance Squadron out of Cannon Air Force Base in New Mexico. Yes, they're doing a fine job. Now those men and women are the backbone of the Air Force. They are the ones that keep our aircraft in the air when we need them the most. So special shout out to them over at Cannon Air Force Base in New Mexico. Man, I'm thinking New Mexico. It's probably a little hot there. Still there is still in a desert. Not sure where Cannon Air Force Base is. So if anybody from Cannon Air Force Base is listening, let me know. Is it pretty hot out there where you're stationed at? And is it always hot? Do you get any kind of relief? Because that would be something if you're not into the heat. That would suck if you're stationed there. But I don't know. You guys are doing a fine job. So thank you for them. Shout out to them. In other sports news, got a great one here. The Illiana Misfits, again founded by two hardcore Devil Dog Marines, took on the Northwest Woodsmen, based out of Schaumburg, Illinois. They came down to host them, they came down to visit the Illiana Misfits, and the first game opener, the home opener, with a score of 48-17, Misfits win. It was a pretty epic battle from start to finish. 48-17, Misfits win their first match of the season. If you haven't been able to catch rugby yet, here's your chance. Come on over to Riverside Park in Hammond, Indiana, located at Calumet and 8094 exit, the Calumet South exit. Look for the park. You'll see the sign. Beautiful park. Next match is the 25th, Saturday the 25th. Join the Illiana Misfits as they take on the Chicago Westside Condors. Kickoff starts at 1 p.m., so check them out. Going on in other news, the 29th, we're going to be doing a live show. BlackSheep Bravo's Friday Night Roundtable Show is going to get together at the St. John Community Township Center, located in Schererville, Indiana. 6 p.m., come on by. You know, a lot of people have been asking me, well, you know, what is it? What does this entail, or what do I have to do? It's nothing, man. Just come out and visit. I have a booth set up there. I'll have a booth and with my mic, and we're going to be broadcasting live. If there's a business that you own or work for and you want to come, give them a shout-out, free advertising. Because let me tell you something, folks. Being on the air costs money these days. And as if you're a business owner, you'll know that advertising isn't cheap. Marketing has a cost to it. So I'm offering this. I'm trying to build up a good community foundation here so that we can help each other out. I need your help. So come on by. Tell us about your business. Tell us about a future event coming up. If you have a school function that needs fundraising help, that's the time to do it. Come on by 1515 Lincoln Highway in Schererville, Indiana, otherwise known as Route 30. The St. John Community Township Center, otherwise known as the Ogre Banquet Hall. So come on by. Check us out. 6 p.m. August 29th. It's a Wednesday. So come on by. All right. So here's my deal. It is now 7:05. Now, ladies and gents, I have a social dilemma here. I have a friend that posted a picture on Facebook of her sweet 16 daughter, okay? Nothing wrong with that. That's not the point where I'm going. Is my question is, as a man these days, do you respond to that? Because I was looking at the comments, you know, and I saw a lot of happy birthdays, good, you know, great looking girl, hugs all around, you know, the typical stuff you would normally see. But as I looked down, there was probably, 60 comments. All, and out of those 60 comments were, you know, out of those 60, four of them were men. The rest were all women. So I was going to comment, right? I was going to say, hey, happy birthday, you know, give all my loves. But the question came to me was, all right, now, if I post something as a man, looking at pictures of a 16-year-old daughter, would I, you know, where is the line these days? Because, you know, nowadays, you don't know what people might think. Like, is this person creeping on the 16-year-old picture and, you know, that 16-year-old girl's picture? Or, you know, what's up with that? So, I don't know, man. That's kind of weird. I wanted to say happy birthday. So, after the show, so hopefully if my friend is watching, you know, you'll understand why I haven't posted anything yet. I wanted to. But it was that little thing, that little voice. And we all know what that little voice is. When that little voice says, I don't know, dude, should you post something? You know, what are people going to think? And normally, I wouldn't give a shit, right? I wouldn't care what people think because I've kind of turned over a new leaf, right? You know, I've kind of turned over a new leaf where I don't want to live in fear of what people may think. But in this case, I don't know. You tell me. Is that something that we should kind of pump the brakes on, you know, and let us know if that's something that we should kind of look into before we post something. I don't know. That's just my own stupidity that I think about. Since I don't sleep much, you know, that's the crazy shit, the warped shit that pops into my head. So, yeah, you tell me, ladies and gents, what is it? And, you know, you just move on. So Katie just gave us a comment. She says, just like it and move on. Don't comment. So, yeah, okay, so just like it. But again, that question comes up. What am I liking? Am I liking the picture of the 16-year-old girl posing, you know, with all, you know what I mean? It's just weird. What am I liking? Am I liking the fact that she's making, you know, the pouty lips and everything? That creeps me out. So like I said, I don't know. I just kind of bypassed it. Didn't even bother with it. So again, for those of y'all that did, y'all, oh my God, I've been watching a lot of HGTV and watching all these barn cabin rebuilders this weekend. I've been saying y'all a lot today, so pardon me for the y'all. All right, I am classically trained. I did not go to Juilliard, but I am classically trained at speaking. Yeah, but anyway, man, yeah, I had just a half a cup of coffee. Can you believe it? Half a cup. That's all it takes. But yeah, going back to my comment here. So there are other times where, again, I think Ogre had brought this up before in one of his shows when it comes down to prom time or, you know, homecoming dances, because it's coming up, you know, it's football season right now. High school football has started. And when the parents start posting up the pictures of their daughters and their gowns and everything, and, you know, us guys, older guys, young and old, I guess it doesn't really matter. You know, it's still considered high school. And if there's a picture up there, do you like it? And why are you liking it? So there's my comment there. Katie, thanks again for commenting there. That was that's going to set me straight. So that kind of answered a little bit and got me in the right direction. So you guys tell me that. You know, let me know what you guys think. If you guys catch this on later in the later recorded version, I'll have it here posted on YouTube, our YouTube channel. So let us know. But yeah, that was one of the things that has been going on in my mind this morning. In other veteran news, want to give another shout out to U.S. Navy. Hello, U.S. Navy. They're going to be sending out a ship over to Colombia on a humanity mission. They're going to send the hospital ship, the USNS Comfort, is heading down over to Colombia to help out with a humanitarian effort down there. So Godspeed, men and women of the USNS Comfort. Safe travels. Come back safely, and doing a hell of a job. Now, if you guys aren't familiar with a USNS, it's a hospital ship. It's a huge, looks like a freight liner, you know, big ass ship, big ass boat, but it's a hospital. It's a hospital on the water. So a lot of personnel there that has to make that operation possible. So to the men and women out there heading down to Colombia, We thank you. Right on. So, yes, we are moving forward this week. It is the 20th. August is well underway. So Labor Day is coming up. I want to find out from you guys, you know, what are you guys doing for Labor Day weekend? Is there a special event that you're going to be going to? And if so, would you like to broadcast it? All right, let us know. If you would like us to come over to your Labor Day party, it's a new segment we're trying this for September for Labor Day. So if you're having a party, backyard barbecue, you have it, what have you, if you got something you would like us to come over and do a live broadcast at your show, promote your party, promote whatever you're promoting there, share the event, let us know. Drop us a line. You can call us at area code 219-232-VETS. That's 219-232-8387. Or you can drop us an email at blacksheepbravo@gmail.com. Head over to our website. We got some new information here. We have a store in the process. We're starting to move up a little bit in the world. We're gaining a little bit of some speed. And we have to be able to supply and give for what the demand is. So what is he talking about? What is this man you're talking about? Well, I'm talking about sponsorship. We're going to be offering and opening the doors now here coming up in the fall for our fall season. If you would like to have your company be mentioned here on any of our shows, whether it's the Morning Sound Off, Monday Motivation with Ogre, Beyond the Thin Blue Line with the Devil Dog, or the Friday Night Roundtable Show, you and your company will be, well, actually your company, more likely, will be mentioned at all of those shows. So let us know, drop us a line, same information as I mentioned before. You know, it's just one of those things that we're going to be traveling a lot more here for 2019, and we could definitely, we need the funds to do that. So again, drop us a line. Don't forget, tonight is Monday Motivation with Ogre. That's at 7 p.m. Central, 8 p.m. Eastern. We're going over to the stately Ogre Manor to see what's going on behind that warp mind. So join us tonight, 7 p.m., Monday Motivation. And he's got a new intro, all right? We'll talk about that tonight. So again, ladies and gentlemen, my time is about out. It is now 7:13 Central, 8:13 Eastern. Again, a quick weather, 72 degrees. It's currently 7:12. Dry start to the day. Chance of showers and thunderstorms. So be ready, folks. All right, my time is up. Join me tonight. I got to run. All right, this is the Spaniard, keeping it tight. Have a great day, ladies and gents. I got to find the right cursor, right now. So anyway, be good. Well, nah, don't be good. It's Monday. You can be whatever you want. You know what? You have permission to be whatever you want to be today, as long as it doesn't hurt anybody, right? All right. I need to refill my coffee. Coffee up. Spaniard out. Well, good morning. It is Friday, August 24th, and if you're tuning in, you got it on the Morning Sound Off with the Spaniard here from Black Sheep Bravo, keeping it tight. I am broadcasting live from Red Zone to Green Zone and everywhere in between. Welcome, everybody. It is the weekend. Welcome. All right. If you're getting ready to start the day, here's your weather forecast for today. Today is mostly cloudy, breezy, and cool. Chance for showers and thunderstorms in the morning, and then another round in the overnight hours. Highs in the lower to mid-70s, wind coming out from the south to southwest at 15 to 25 miles per hour, gusting up to 30. Tonight, partly to mostly cloudy skies and breezy with a chance of showers and thunderstorms. Low temperatures in the lower 60s. Again, wind coming out from the south, 15 to 25. Tomorrow, to start the real weekend, partly to mostly sunny, chance of showers and thunderstorms in the morning, highs to the lower to mid-80s, and again, still with that wind coming out of the southwest, 10 to 15 miles an hour. And then wrapping up the weekend on Sunday, partly cloudy to mostly sunny skies, a few showers and thunderstorms, possibly late in the evening, temperatures warming up to around 90 with heat indexes. Or is that indices? I don't know. You literature and English buffs out there, tell me if heat indices or indexes. near 100 degrees, but that's this weekend. So overall, I don't know, it's not going to be a great weekend, but nonetheless, it's still a weekend. So go out there, do what you got to do, make the best of it, and just remember, the more you smile, the less it hurts. That's a public service announcement from yours truly, the Spaniard. So, a couple shout-outs. Good morning to everyone. It is Red Friday. We want to recognize those, everyone who is still deployed overseas, serving our United States Armed Forces. And I want to give a good shout-out today to out to New York. This is Devil Dog's territory. So, Devil Dog, if you're listening, hold on, let me see here. Let me grab something. Devil Dog, if you're listening, this falls out to your neck of the woods. So, this goes out to the New York Army National Guard A Company, 101st Signal Battalion. They have a special person there in their ranks. Specialist Nicole McKenzie was on her way home from the armory, and when she deceased, she observed on a bridge, there was a boy standing there, and it looked like he was about to jump, and sure enough, the boy did, and fell several feet down, so she jumped into action and helped the officers rescue this boy. She used her military training, first response training, to get in there and help that boy, bring him back, and get him back to where he needed to be. The boy was a little bit troubled, so again, Devil Dog, this came from the Bronx. This the Andrews, A-N-D-R-U-S, the Andrus campus in the Bronx. That's it's a school for young children who are struggling a little bit behaviorally. And evidently, I guess this boy wasn't having a good day, and let the emotions get the best of him. But luckily, Specialist Nicole McKenzie was there to jump at the accident and use her military training to good use. So, want to thank her. And that's again about veterans and our military folks. Is that it's a profession, but also it's a calling. It's one of those things where. You know, some people don't like the outdoors, some people don't like certain elements about the military, but when all is said and done, I think we all have that ability. I've seen people just, and I don't want to say ordinary, but I'm just saying just people that just go about their daily lives, you know, without hurting anyone or causing anybody any stress. They go about their day, but when something happens, they spring into action. They definitely spring into action. Which is good to see nowadays. We got to help each other out, you know. Come hell or high water, we are a powerful nation, strengthened by the people who are in it. So, just want to thank everybody for everything that you do. Thank you for joining or following us here on Facebook and on YouTube. Again, this is a work in progress. For those of you guys who are not familiar with BlackSheep Bravo. It's just a brainchild of mine, a dream of mine. I've always wanted to be into radio, into broadcasting, but just didn't really have the knowledge or know-how, and this is a project where I want to get primarily veterans. I want to get veterans engaged. I want them to tell me what they're up to, what works for them, their hobbies, their interests, what they do for a living, if their military life really prepared them for civilian life or to life in general. But that's what it's about. It's a soundboard. I want to hear from you and the people around you, the families, the friends. So it's not strictly, primarily, just for veterans. It's for everybody who knows a veteran or loves a veteran or cares for a veteran, hangs out with them. You know it. You know, this is what that's for. So again, please let us know how we can help. If you got something you want to share, or if you are in a unit that would like to be highlighted here on the morning sound off in the mornings, drop me a line at blacksheepbravo@gmail.com or even comment here below. Let us know. I'd love to do a shout out to more units out there, both here in country and abroad. Yes, Ogre, I said abroad. So speaking of which, got a couple announcements for tonight. For today. After this show at 0900, 9 o'clock Central Time, 10 a.m. Eastern Time, catch me over on WJOB, 1230 a.m. and 104.7 FM, as well as Facebook Live on the WJOB Facebook page to catch another exciting episode of Veterans Views starting at 0900. Again, catch me over there. We got a couple guests lined up tonight, so be sure to call in. If you have anything you'd like to talk about or share, that number is 219-845-1100. So write this down, call me, say hi, and the rest of the crew. Again, that number is 219-845-1100. That'll be at 9 o'clock. The lines open at 9 o'clock, so give us a call at that time and let us know. Also, tonight, if you are around, we have a new change in the lineup. Not really a change, really, but more of a time change. We are going to change the time to kind of balance things out. We're heading into the fall. We've had some consultants go over some things with us, and we found out that 8 p.m. tonight will be the new time for the BlackSheep Bravo Friday Night Roundtable Show. So that's 8 p.m. So mark your calendars, please. You don't want to miss this. This is going to be a good one tonight. We are introducing a new host to the show. You don't want to miss it. Very interesting person. Not going to say who it is, or not going to give out anything. You're going to have to wait around and watch. You know, the anticipation is worth it. So let me tell you, tonight, 8 p.m. Central, 9 p.m. Eastern, the Friday Night Roundtable Show. Catch us here on Facebook Live. And you can, it's interactive, so you can comment as the show goes on. If there's something you want to share, go ahead and send it out there. And then we'll be posting it again on our Facebook, on our YouTube channel. That's where everything goes after this. So anyway, that's that for that. Okay, in other news. Tomorrow morning, it's rugby. Saturday's a rugby day, and our Ileana Misfits will host the Chicago Westside Condors at Riverside Park in Hammond. Riverside Park is located right off of Calumet and 8094. You exit 8094 Calumet South and go east, right there at the light. I believe it's River Road, I can't remember, but you can't miss it. It's a big park right there on the left as you're coming off the expressway. Kickoff is at 1. It's going to be a battle, ladies and gentlemen. This is a rivalry unlike no other. It is going to be right from the start. So if you've never seen rugby before, come on down, grab yourself a seat, grab yourself a beer, and watch the battle unravel. So there you have it. Tomorrow, 1 p.m., Riverside Park, Ileana Misfits. Take on the Chicago Westside Condors. And next week, Wednesday, August 29th, we will be at the St. John Community Township Center, otherwise known as Ogre Hall, for our live broadcast show. So here, again, I've gotten a lot of feedback on questions on what is this all about? Well, it's just a remote location that we're gonna broadcast live. We're gonna have some topics to talk about. I'm gonna have some guests come on board. But if there's something you wanna share, come on down, we'll promote your business, your events, your website, whatever it is. This is my way of saying thank you for supporting BlackSheep Bravo and our veterans. So come on down Wednesday, August 29th, St. John Township Center in Sherrill, Indiana. The address is 1515 Lincoln Highway, or otherwise known as Route 30. Come on down. So it is currently 8:09 on the East Coast. 7:09 in Chicago. One last thing. All right. Before I get out, because my time is almost up. Veterans, here's the question, the survey for the weekend. I want you guys to interact. I need to know. I'm writing a second book, and this is research. So this, I ain't bullshitting here. I need your input. So vets, where was the most shittiest place you were ever stationed? And tell me about it. Just a quick blur of the line. Where was the most shittiest place you were ever stationed? And for everyone else, tell me this. Where was the worst place you had to go for work? All right? Was it, you know, it's gotta be work related. So you sent someplace for work where it was just, you just did not have an enjoyable time. I wanna hear about that as well. So make sure you comment below. And this will be, this show as well as the Monday show will be compiled into one video and sent over to our YouTube channel with the enhanced version of it. So. Thanks again for watching. My time is up. It is now 7:10, 8:10 on the East Coast. This is the Spaniard from BlackSheep Bravo, keeping it tight. Don't forget, catch us tonight, 8 p.m. Central, 9 p.m. Eastern, for a special show. You don't want to miss it. So anyway, all right, ladies and gents, that's my time. You guys have a great weekend. Stay safe. Again, the beaches are going to be still a little hazardous out here in Lake Michigan, so... be careful going out there. Anyway, it's been a great time. See you tonight, ladies and gents. This is the Spaniard from BlackSheep Bravo, keeping it tight. Have a great day.